guys, without hitting the heights today, we should have had 3 points.
Definitely. An unspectacular first half, and then came alive second half, and probably should have scored 3 or 4 goals, missed 2 penalties. Just turned up to one of them days. Very, very frustrating for all, fans included. But showed some credit to get back in the game, and then, as you say, should have then gone on and won it.
First half, we were very sluggish again, a bit like against Aldershot, and a really poor goal to concede in the manner we did.
Yeah, it was lacklustre again, and like you say, you're trying to build the lads up to know where they can go in the league and things like that. And then the contrast of the second half with how we started the second half with a bit of intensity. We got in between their defensive and midfielders. And then we looked like we've got the impetus to go on and win the game, but it's just one of them unfortunate days. You have 2 penalties, and you know the lads don't mean to miss them. That's football. That's why we all love it. But it's a tough one to take tonight. Yeah,
Cookie had done so well in getting the equaliser, which was a much harder chance really than the penalty he missed.
Yeah, unbelievable finish from him. The big man. You know, that's what he does. I think that the key today's game was the first goal. Whichever team got that, that was going to give them something to hang on to and be plucky about. If we'd gone and got it with the big fan base behind us today, then that would have knocked their confidence straight away, and their mindset has to be one of negativity at the moment because of where they are in the league. And you know, the goal from our point of view is disappointing on 2 fronts. You know, how can you have that much time to run into in on our goal? And then could Joel, first time we've questioned him this season, to be fair, could he have done a little bit better? So disappointing on all fronts, as all goals against you always are. You can point the finger at somebody or something that happens in the game. But some words said at half time, and the performance changed round, and then substitutes we felt had almost changed the game round for us and won it for us. But for 2 good saves or poor penalties, however you flip it round, you don't expect to miss 2 in a game, but you see it all the time where people do, so we have to just stay together and continue to build strongly as a group and keep the positives from this game.
George Williams missed the games today with a foot injury. Can you tell us anything about that?
Did it in training?
Yeah, it's a weird one.
With Barnsley. Just felt a little twist. It's a ligament in the front of the knee joint. Of the ankle joint. It's an unusual one to do, but he tried very hard to be fit with some painkillers and then a strapping, but it was possibly too risky.
That's a decision.
But Dave Symington came in and
I was just going to say that he did
fine. Played like he'd been there all season. Yeah, it was like, yeah, George wasn't, yeah, away. He was excellent. And if you play at League 2 and right back for 30, 40 games, then you know we knew what we were bringing. He is predominantly a right back, but because of his excellent delivery and his pace, people use him further forward, which is what we've done. So he's given us food for thought, and it'll give him a lot of confidence. I think he needed that performance.
And now we go to, we have a midweek off this week, so it does give you a chance for players to rest any little niggles. And then we go to Altrincham, who are a bit of an enigma, really. Near the bottom of the league, but have beaten Tranmere, Cheltenham and Grimsby at Moss Lane.
Yeah, no, they've done what they do, I think. They've surprised a lot of teams, and they'll be playing good football around it. So we'll get our reports in this week and take positives from our performance today, and then move on and try and come up with a game plan and a system, and then ultimately, you know, a mentality that is stronger than at times today.
Just while I'm sure all the fans are pretty disappointed we didn't win today, a year ago we lost at home to Runcorn Town, and we were at the top of the Conference North, but I think then if we'd have forecasted a year on that we would be drawing at home at Kidderminster and would have been disappointed with that, you'd probably have taken that.
Yeah, the fans have got to remain positive even through frustrating afternoons like this one, and I'm sure everybody in the ground, I know there was one or two, you know, disgruntled comments came at the end, but you know, to miss 2 penalties, to have one disallowed that probably shouldn't have been in the last minutes of the game. If we'd won 4-1, then everybody would be singing everybody's praises, and we'd have the best group of players, you know, we've had for ages. So they're the ups and downs of football. That's why we love it. That's why we're in it. They're the margins that can, you know, excite or disgruntle, and we were, you know, unfortunately on the wrong end of it. So we have to remain positive. So do the fans. You know, the journey has gone ups and downs. That's this league, and it's hard to take when you're paying money to come in and you want your team to win every game. But you know, sometimes it doesn't. And if you then look at it in a positive side again, we picked 3 points up on Tuesday night away from home, and we've got a point today. So if you continue to take four from two games, then you're going to be moving up the league.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you very much.
Cheers. Thank you.